how to recover data from any Mac. In this video, we'll learn how to remove any hard drive from any Mac, the adapters that we'll need for this process, how to recover the actual files with the adapters and the hard drives, and how to restore permanently deleted files even if you emptied your trash can. First, let's get some basic concepts out of the way. Inside of any Mac, whether it's an iMac or a MacBook, there is a hard drive that has all of your personal data and files stored on it. The hard drive can be easily removed and hooked up to an adapter and plugged into a working MacBook so that you can restore your data and your work files. On newer MacBooks after 2012, the actual hard drive is a solid-state disk and can be easily removed with one screw and pulled out of the socket. For this drive, there's a special adapter that needs to be plugged into the drive. Once plugged into the adapter, and then plugged into the SATA to the USB adapter, we'll be able to plug this drive also into any OS X computer and be able to restore any of the files. On iMacs, the hard drives are a little bigger and a little more difficult to get to. You'll have to remove your glass and the LCD panel. But once the glass and the LCD panel have been removed, you can also access this hard drive as well. It's a 3.5 inch SATA hard drive. You can plug in a SATA to a USB converter cable for this hard drive. Once you've plugged the converter cable into the drive, you can plug it into any working computer. Once plugged in, you can go to Go, Computer, and select your drive from the list. Select Users folder, select your specific username, and here you can recover files from documents, from your Downloads folder, from your Pictures folder, or any other folder that's on the hard drive. This process is exactly the same across all drives. Take a 2.5 inch standard laptop SATA drive, for instance. Or an SSD drive from a MacBook Air or a more modern MacBook Pro. Once plugged into the adapter and the converter cable plugged in, you can plug it in and restore any of the data. Although this seems easy, there are a lot of different converters for different MacBook years. We'll go over a couple of converters here. This specific converter will convert any 2012 only SSD. This one is for 2013 to 2015 more modern MacBooks. This one's for 2010 to 2011 MacBook Airs. For all other standard hard drives like iMac, legacy hard drives that are 3.5 inches, and regular MacBook legacy laptops that are 2.5 inches, all we need is the SATA to the USB cable. Click on the Apple logo and go to About This Mac. Here we can find out the specific Mac type. This is a laptop that's 15 inches in 2010. Using this example, we can track down exactly the adapter that we need. Navigate to appledollars.com through the Safari browser. Select Troubleshooting. In the Troubleshooting page, find Data Recovery. scroll down, here you'll find a table of all the Macs and all years and the adapters that you'll need. We have a 15-inch 2010 MacBook, so we'll need just a basic SATA to USB cable. Look up the converter that you need for your Mac. Okay, let's return to the AppleDollars.com homepage. Now select MacBooks, your MacBook size, and your MacBook year. We'll need to watch the video on how to remove the hard drive. Locate the hard drive video on the interactive video map and watch the video. AppleDollars.com has the videos on how to remove any hard drive from any Mac, so all Macs are covered. Once you watch the video on how to remove your specific hard drive, we're confident that you now have all the knowledge and skills to be able to recover your data. Now let's learn how to recover files that have been deleted from the trash can. Here we have three images on our desktop that we're using as an example. We're going to select these three images and throw them away into the trash can. Then we're going to right-click on the trash can and empty it. The OS X will warn you that these files cannot be returned. Go to Safari and navigate to AppleDollars.com. Select Troubleshooting. Now select Data Recovery. Scroll all the way down to the bottom of the page. Here you'll find the link to EaseUS Data Recovery Download. Click that. This is a free program. Go ahead, open it up. Drag it into your applications folder. You can now log into your applications folder and execute the program. You'll be prompted for your password. In the interface of the program, go ahead and select all the files that you wish to recover. Then click Next. Select the drive that you wish to recover your files from. El Capitan is our native drive. Click Scan. This might take several minutes, but it'll scan your entire hard drive. Here it'll hierarch the folders that most of your files will be in. Your trash bin will be under Users Trash. Here you can select the files. You can also click Preview View to see what files you can restore. Go ahead, select the files that you want to restore and click Recover. You'll be asked where you want the recovery files to be placed. We selected Desktop. Click Continue. The recovered files are placed in multiple folders on your desktop now. You can go ahead and exit out of the program. Locate the recovery file folder. Open it up and page through the subfolders. Now find the files that have been recovered. Open them up to make sure and check that they work. This concludes our tutorial. Thank you for watching. Check out more videos at AppleDollars.com.